Hello everyone, I am Lady Morgana and welcome to my channel. In this video I will award the what the fuck finger to people who deserve it. I was going to add the area manager to this list but chose not to yet. So, let's get started. Attractive women are less likely to be trusted in the workplace. Studies show that managing appearance is a fine line for professional women to walk. There's both a bonus and a penalty to being attractive in the workplace. Recent studies suggest that women who take more care of their appearance earn higher incomes, but other studies indicate the opposite. Attractive women are seen less capable or less qualified for their positions. Some women don't get hired because of their appearance. The women who shout out, "Thin privilege," should hear this. Some companies prefer to hire or give promotions to less attractive women, because they think the less attractive woman can get the job done without any biased circumstances. Men quite often don't trust women in the workplace. Upper management won't give a manager job to a very attractive woman because they feel that she will be distracting and that she may not perform her job well. It turns out that the bubble of beauty can make certain aspects of life much more difficult. Not being taken seriously at work, a place many women found to be fueled by implicit sexist prejudices. It's true. The workplace is filled with sexist prejudices, and I remember experiencing it myself. I was always told that I was too pretty to be work at the place I was working at when I was in my 20s. It was annoying. I used to see women who were unattractive rise up to becoming supervisors or managers. It's still that way too. No matter what company you work for. I have never expressed a position in management, so I really don't care, but I have seen sexism firsthand. So, this What the Fuck Award goes to all those who are biased, sexist, prejudiced just because they judge a book by its cover. Don't put wasp nest material in your vagina. A while ago, Gwyneth Paltrow came up with the vagina J-Dag. It's supposed to help improve your sex life and balance your menstrual cycle, and intensify feminine energy, among other things. However, the claims were unfounded, and thank God not every woman was doing it. So, there was something I came across online. Putting a wasp nest in your vagina. I laughed right out of my seat. They were selling balls to put in your vagina. Now, the latest answer to what's in your vagina is wasp nests. Medicinal paste of bark and wasp excreta that you can put inside your vagina. Oak galls, also known as oak apples, come from oak trees indigenous to Asia Minor and Persia. It is known as manjakani in Malay or majipal in Indian. They are produced when the bark or leaves of the oak tree Quercus infectoria are penetrated by the female gall wasp, Synapse galitinctorii, who lays its eggs inside. The spontaneous chemical reaction caused by the penetration stimulates the bark or leaves to produce a roundish hard ball called an oak gall. The claims are that it can tighten your vagina, improve your sex life, restore the elasticity of the uterine wall, clean your vagina, and improve your general health and well-being. That's a lot of claims. They didn't say whether it can park your car as well. How much scientific evidence is offered to support these claims? The big zero, as in zero. Now, this definitely deserves the What the Fuck Award, don't you agree? Next, this goes to my cousin, Chris. I recently found out that she has lost quite a bit of weight. I saw it on her Facebook page, through another Facebook page I had set up 5 years ago. That Facebook page is associated with this channel. According to one of my cousins, she lost weight because of a health issue. If it wasn't thyroid problems, then diabetes. Medical reasons? Well, that figures. She was a behemoth. I don't give a fuck if she lost weight. That never was the issue. To me, I still remember what she said and did online. After she blocked me, she could have just left it as that, but no. She had to insult me, as a writer, and spewed out disparaging remarks about a copy of a book I gave her to read, rate, and review. She never really read the book, and later when I asked her what she thought about it, she said, "I didn't understand it, so I use it as a coaster for my cups." She said with a touch of contempt. Sure, you're going to say, well, that is constructive criticism. I say no. It's clear that it was mean-spirited and malicious. She is one of those haters who believe that books that are not sold in stores such as Target or other retail stores are not worth buying. That wasn't the only thing she said about me, which family members saw, but what can I do, right? As far as I know, that bitch still lives in the same town that I do too. Lucky for me, she kept her rude and disparaging remark off of where the book is for sale. So, because of all that, I give her the what the fuck award. Yes, sometimes you have to say fuck off, we are only human. Feelings come with being human. This is my second what the fuck award video. I don't like making videos like this, but sometimes I just have to let it out. Have a nice evening or morning. Next video will consist of health and beauty issues. Stay safe and be blessed.
You dropped the bomb on me.
But you turned me on.
You dropped the bomb on me.